Hi everyone, thanks for joining the talk. This is a joint work with IMDEA Software Institute, and this talk is about the distribution of unwanted app on Android. Android has become the most popular operating system with over 2.5 billion active devices and 75% of the mobile device market share. A major reason behind Android's success is its open environment that allows vendors to perform OS customization and also offers affordable access to new app developers that can distribute their apps via the official or alternative markets. Unfortunately, this openness comes with a cost, since abusive developers have also easy access to the ecosystem for distributing unwanted apps. In this work, we use the term unwanted apps to refer to various classes of threats, from traditional malware, like ransomware, to potentially unwanted programs, like adware, or even for stalkerware apps. AV vendors keep reporting ever-increasing numbers of unwanted app detections in the last years. What remains unknown is how these apps are actually installed on user devices. This is because installations on Android can happen in different ways. By default, only installations via the official Play Store market are allowed. However, users have the option to enable installation from third parties that will allow applications like alternative markets to operate properly. Even then, these apps need to obtain the appropriate permission and notify the user before its installation. While apps are largely distributed through markets, other smaller alternative distribution vectors also exist, like web downloads, instant messaging, or even bloatware. Bloatware apps are typically developed by phone vendors or other entities in the Android supply chain and offer unclear functionality to the end user. Interestingly, these applications often run with system privileges and may perform even silent installations. Now, another possible distribution vector is actually backup restoration, in which users restore previously saved apps in the cloud, typically when these users clone apps from an old to a newer phone. However, the question here is how each vector contributes in the distribution of unwanted apps. In this work, we perform a large-scale analysis of unwanted app distribution by analyzing 12 different distribution vectors and assess how risky each vector can be, as well as the risk of specific installers within the same category. In the process, we also measure the prevalence of unwanted apps on real devices and analyze the top unwanted families and signers. Now, at the core of our study are actually reputation logs that capture the presence of 34 million APKs and their who installs who relationships on 12 million Android devices for 4 months, from June to September 2019. Now, a very important part of our dataset is actually the installation events that capture the parent-child relationships as extracted by the operating system API, and specifically the Android's package install, in which we are able to obtain the name of the parent package for each installed APK. In this talk, the terms parent and installer are interchangeable. Now let's move to the first part of our study related to unwanted app encounters. We identify unwanted apps using a common practice of collecting the AV labels of APKs using the virus total service, and we collect VT reports for a subset of APKs that are specially selected for the needs of this study. We decide if an APK is malicious or not using the number of AV engines that detect it. And although we measure prevalence for any virus total threshold, we define the threshold to 4 for the analysis of the distribution vectors. This threshold actually aligns with prior work that proposed thresholds between 3 and 14. Now, any APK that falls below this threshold or for which no virus total report was collected is actually considered benign. And this means that our prevalence estimate is a lower bound. Now, using this threshold, we are actually able to measure that at least 18% of the devices in our dataset have one malware encounter during the 4 months period that we analyzed. Now, if we compare this to prior measurements on Windows Enterprise host, this indicates that Android devices have an unwanted app prevalence similar and possibly slightly higher than that of Windows Enterprise host. We should note here that there is a difference in time between our work and prior measurements. Now, We also separate unwanted apps between UP and malware. And we actually observe here that both classes equally affect Android users. Now, a closer look on the top unwanted signers shows that the abuse of publicly available cryptographic keys, like that from the AOSP project, is actually a common practice. And we see many different applications that are actually signed using these keys. Now, the interesting part is that we also see actors abusing the generic keys coming from online app generator service. These services are actually used to facilitate inexperienced users for developing new Android applications, but also we see that unwanted app developers leverage these services for signing their application. Now, also a look on the top unwanted families shows that most of these are actually PUP, including abusive ad libraries, but also we see notorious malware families like the Necro and the Triada Trojans. Now, let's move on and actually answer the main question of our study, that of how are unwanted apps distributed on Android. Now, for answering this, we actually use the who installs who relationships, as we said, and we do a manual categorization of the installer apps into 12 categories, each corresponding to a different vector. And then we assess how risky each vector can be. Now, our manual categorization covers only 15% of the installers, but this corresponds to over 96% of the installation events. Now, in this plot, we actually see the percentage of installation coming from each distribution vector, including both benign and unwanted app installation. Among those 12 vectors, we also see the package installer, and this vector represents installation for which the Android API reports as a parent the package installer. Therefore, for those installations, we do not know the exact parent application. Now, let's see the most important thing, like how each vector contributes on the unwanted app distribution. And here is the plot that shows this. Now, what we immediately see here is that the Play Store is the main distribution vector for both benign and unwanted app installations. However, only 0.6% of the APKs installed via Play Store are actually unwanted. This means that cookie defenses work, but still a small fraction of apps that evade those defenses, due to the market's popularity, results in a large number of installations. And this highlights the need for further research on protecting the Play market. Now, the second largest vector here is the package installer, for which we said we cannot identify the exact unwanted app. But the third one comes very close are alternative markets that are responsible for 10% of the unwanted app installations in our dataset. Now, the interesting thing here is that we observe that on average, installations coming from alternative markets are 5 times riskier than that from Play Store. However, this risk really varies depending on the alternative market that we are talking about. For example, as we can see at the plot at the bottom, we see that there are markets like Amazon and Vivo that can be almost as safe as Play Market. But also we see markets like Huawei and Bazaar that can be up to 19 times riskier. Now, another surprisingly distribution vector of unwanted apps are bloatware applications that are responsible for 6% of all the unwanted app installations in the dataset. As we said, this is worrisome due to the fact that these applications often have system privileges and the removal by security tools may not be possible because these apps may be installed on the read-only partition of the operating system. Now, the fact that we actually see installations coming from bloatware applications show us evidence that there is ad-based monetization coming from device vendors and carriers. Now, moving on, we actually see another very surprisingly distribution vector, that of backup restoration, that is responsible for almost 5% of all unwanted app installations in the dataset. As we said, these are installations that typically happen when users clone apps from an old phone to a newer one. But also, this shows us that unwanted apps may survive phone changes, which is quite surprising. It also highlights the opportunity for backup apps to improve the defenses against unwanted apps, if any, during the cloning process. Now, in this work, we also try to make a very conservative lower bound estimation of the distribution of unwanted apps via commercial paper install services. And this is a very conservative estimation because we can identify only two commercial PPIs, that of Iron Source and Digital Derby. However, we actually see something very interesting, that these installations have half the risk compared to Play Store. And basically, if we compare this with prior work that analyzed commercial PPI services on Windows, that showed that these services on Windows are responsible for 25% of the distribution of PUP downloads, show us that basically on Android, this distribution is far less, and show us also that these services have actually improved the filtering of abusive advertisers. Now, I would also like to show here the relative risk of the main distribution vectors in comparison to Play Store, that is the main distribution vector and also one of the safest ones. As we see, the relative risk really varies. Interestingly, installing apps you receive via instant messaging is on average 5 times riskier than that from Play Store. But also, by far, the riskiest proposition for users are web downloads that can be on average 6 times riskier. Now I would like to close this talk with the main takeaways. In this work, we first measured the prevalence of unwanted apps on Android devices and compared it with that of Windows Enterprise host. This comparison shows that unwanted app prevalence is slightly higher on Android, despite the main security improvements in the Android ecosystem. We also analyzed the main distribution vectors of unwanted apps and saw that Play Store is the largest vector for both benign and unwanted apps. However, it still remains one of the safest, but our work also highlights the need for further research on protecting Play Store. Finally, we presented a plethora of less understood vectors from those we actually see the alarmingly high percentage of installations coming from bloatware apps, as well as the high portion of unwanted app installations coming via backup applications. Thank you very much.